Hello students, today we will see the next topic is relationship in the UML diagram. Relationship is another most important building block of UML. It shows how the elements are associated with each other and this association describes the functionality of an application. There are four kinds of relationship in UML. First is dependency. Dependency is a semantic relationship between two things in which changes in one element also affects the other one. Dependency state change a specification of one things may affect another things and that uses it but not the reverse. Graphically, dependency relationship is represented with a dashed line with an arrow. See this. This is the symbol of dependency and this is the example for dependency. Dependency part and independent part. Then second thing is association. Association is a structural relationship that describes a set of links and a link is connected between objects. Association a relationship is used when we want to show structural relationship. Association is basically a set of links that connects elements of an UML model and it describes how many objects are taking part in the relationship. Graphically, association is represented as a solid line. See, this is the symbol for association and this is the example employee. Employee is the whole part. This is the example for association. Then third is generalization. Generalization is a relationship between general things that is superclass or parent class and a specific thing that is subclass or child class. Generalization can be defined as a relationship between which connects a specified elements with a generalized element and it is basically describe the inheritance relationship in the world of objects. It portrays the relationship between general things like parent class or superclass and a specific kind of the things like child class or subclass. And it is used to describe the concept of inheritance. It is denoted by a straight line followed by an empty arrowhead at one side. See, this is the symbol for a generalization and this is the example for generalization, subclass, parent class. Then fourth is realization. Realization can be defined as a relationship in which two elements are connected. One element describes some responsibility which is not implemented and other is implement them. And this relationship exists in case of interfaces and it is denoted by a dotted line with an empty arrowhead at one side. See, this is the symbol for realization and this is the example of realization, HTML parser. Realize or implements the interface to the parser, it defines the interface. Then aggregation, it refers to the information of a particular class as a result of one class being aggregated or built as a collection. For example, aggregations container classes are not strongly dependent on the life cycle of the container. And as composition, it is very similar to the aggregation relationship, with only difference being its key purpose. It emphasizes key purpose with emphasizing the dependencies contained classes to the life cycle of the container class. And this is connected class will be container in the destroyed class. For example, here car and engine. This is the symbol for composition and second is car and passenger. This is the empty decision symbol is aggregation and filled symbol is the composition. Then multiplicity, it is the active logical association when the cardinality of the class in a relation of to the another is being depicted and it is also called as the cardinality. For example, company and employee, here one is exactly one, no one and no less. Then 0 to 1, that means 0 or 1. star represent many. 0 to star, that means 0 to many, and 1 to star, that means 1 or many. Then diagrams in the UML. A diagram is a graphical presentations of the set of elements, most often rendered as a connected graph of a vertical, that means things, and arcs means relationship. There are three classification of UML diagram. First is structural diagram, second is behavioral diagram, and third is architectural diagram. Then first is structural diagram, a type of diagram that depicts the elements of a specification that are irrespective of a time, and this diagram shows the things in a system being modeled. Then second is behavioral diagram, a type of diagram that depicts behavioral features of a system or a business process. And this diagram shows what should happen in the system and also describe how the objects interact with each other to create functioning system. Then third is architectural diagram, a subset of behavioral diagram which emphasize object interaction, and this diagram include communication, interaction overview, sequence, and timing diagram. Then UML diagrams include such a nine diagram. First is class diagram, a structural diagram that shows a set of classes, interfaces, collaboration, and their relationship. Then second is object diagram, structural diagram that shows a set of objects and their relationship. Then third is use case diagram, a behavioral diagram that shows a set of use cases and actors and their relationship. Then sequence diagram, a behavioral diagram that shows interactions emphasizing the time ordering of the messages. Then fifth is collaboration diagram, a behavioral diagram that shows an interaction emphasizing the structural organization of the object that send and receive the message. Then sixth is a state chart diagram, a behavioral diagram that shows a state machine emphasizing the event order behavior of an object. Then activity diagram, a behavioral diagram that shows a state machine emphasizing the flow from activity to activity. Then next is component diagram, a structural diagram that shows a set of components and their relationship. And last is a deployment diagram. This diagram shows distribution, delivery, and installation of the part that make up the physical system. These are the nine diagrams included in UML.